हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर यस्टरडेज लेक्चर मॉडर्न डेवलपमेंट इन कॉमर्स। यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टडीड मॉडर्न डेवलपमेंट इन कॉमर्स। In that we have studied what are the directions of development. So researchers have tried to make the commerce so that they can process heavy and wider labs to increase production. Efforts are also there to increase the speed of the commerce, which is expressed in nips per minute. And today we have reached a level of 500 nips per minute. Some companies have tried to increase the heads of the machine, just like circle level, but they have not succeeded. So yesterday we have studied computer-aided process development, and with the help of that we have been able to reduce acceleration of the detaching roller. We also studied precise combing and concentric moment of nippers. With this development, the comber is able to do the superior fiber selection, and short fibers are removed and long fibers are going to the sliver. So today we will study next topic, that automation in combers, and then RoboLab, that is automatic lab change, then bat fishing, then universal lab clothing, and next is electronic feed adjustment. So we start with automation. So these days we are having combers with two kind of options, that transport automation and machine automation. So automation in commerce is of two types, transport and machine automation. In transport automation, two automation systems are available, that is semi-automatic transport and fully automatic transport. For countries like India, Bangladesh, and Pakistan and Sri Lanka, where the labor cost is less as compared to European countries, semi-automatic transport system is preferred, and fully automatic models are also available, but they are costly. So that's why industry people are hesitating to purchase these fully automatic transport systems. But these days many companies, big companies, are opting for this fully automatic transport system in combers. So first of all, semi-automatic transport system. So in this case, we are taking help of lab trolleys. In this system, trolleys are automatically loaded with labs at a filling station in front of lab former. Then the trolley is manually transferred to combers, where uploading is performed semi-automatically. Means manual help is required and worker intervention is required. The transport scheme with semi-automatic lab trolleys, four combers, two left and two right, with lab former in between, is generally preferred, in which four combers, two left and two right, and in the center this trolley's transport scheme is followed. So in this case, we are getting labs from the lab former, and all the eight labs are loaded on trolley, and worker is transporting these trolleys to the respective combers, and eight reserve labs are put up behind the eight working labs. In case of fully automatic lab transport system, overhead transport device is used to carry the labs in groups of eight at a time to the combers. So this is fully automatic, and labs are traveling at their own in groups, and at eight labs are transferred at a time to every comber. So these labs are traveling overhead and going to the comber. In this case, an additional installation is required between lab former and comber, which is called lab standstill, and which is used to load the labs into the overhead carriers in the right direction, that is prepared for automatic piecing on the comber. So the labs are put in such a way so that they are ready for auto piecing, while the whole loading, unloading and transportation operation is performed without intervention by operator. In semi-automatic, worker intervention is required, whereas in fully automatic, no worker intervention is required. And this is a significant development that labs are put and then auto piecing is also a significant development which doesn't require any worker intervention. So RoboLab, next point is RoboLab automatic lab change. So automatic lab change concept is called RoboLab by some companies, and RoboLab and batch piecing, they are significant development over the last 10 and 20 years, which has eased the work of the worker. How the batch piecing takes place? In case of batch piecing, automatic batch piecing, first step is detaching the bat. Bat means lab sheet. Means the last, in this case, it is not necessary that all the labs will finish at the same time. So whatever lab sheet is left, that is going to the waste. So all the labs are finished at the same time, and all the new eight labs are fed at the same time. Even if one or two labs are having some remaining lab sheets, that is not consumed. Previously, what happens that worker changes the lab when it exhausts, and all the labs are exhausting at different times. So he's always busy in changing the labs. So much time is wasted and consumed for lab change at different times. So in this automatic lab change, all the labs are prepared with length measuring unit having same length. And even if there is some variation in the length, so the last portion of the lab is going to the pneumatic pressure and waste. So what are the operations? First is detaching the bat, detaching the lab sheet, which is left on some labs. Then removal of the bat remains. Whatever the lab sheet is remaining, that is going to a suction tube. And then cleaning the tube, empty tube on which lab was there. So changing the labs means empty tubes are taken back and new lab is introduced. Then with the help of suction, preparing bats means the new lab sheet is in ready position to feed and piecing bat with aerobic system. So air pressure is there, air suction is there. So aerobic system picks the new lap sheet and piecing takes place of the lap sheet, which was previously running in the machine, and new lap sheet. So both lap sheets are pieced and the machine starts. So this auto bat piecing has eased the worker efforts, and it is easy for the worker to work on these machines. So RoboLab means automatic lap change. So time of the worker was mostly consumed in changing the lap sheets and then piecing of the lap sheets. So all these two operations are performed automatically now. So these are the significant developments. Next point is universal lab clothing. So these days, the lab clothing which is used is of sawtooth clothing, and the specifications are chosen in such a way that it can comb a vast and large variety of cotton, and it is not necessary to change the clothing for different types of cotton. The life of the sawtooth clothing is also good. They are self-cleaning and easy to clean, and they are made in sections also. That suppose there are four or five sections. So the first portion of the clothing, which is combing the material, contains the wire points, which are coarser, and then medium, and then fine clothing, and then finest clothing. So four sections are there, and the clothing is universal lab clothing, that we are purchasing only one set of clothing and we are putting it on the half lab, and already four sections are made on it, and it can comb a vast large variety of cotton. Another significant development is electronic feed adjustment. These days, every parameter of the machine is set electronically on the panel of the machine. That's just like touchscreen mobile. So previously, for changing the feed per nip, if you want to increase the feed per nip or decrease feed per nip, then we had to change the gears, 16 teeth, 18 teeth, 20 teeth. But these days, we have to change electronically on the panel of the machine. So all the adjustment related to feed are changed electronically. The timing of the feed, feed per nip, and tension in the lap sheet, whether it is 10%, 15%, more or less. So we can change it electronically. So these features are not common features. Some machines may have some of these features. Another machine may have all of these features. So we have tried that to compile the developments which has taken place in the field of Comber machine. And most of the points have been explained. And research is a continuous process. So every year, every month, new developments are coming and different models are there. So it is not necessary that a model should have all these features. It may or may not have all these features, but we must know that what are the common features which are generally found on the modern Comber machine. With this, we finish the lecture on modern developments in Comber. Thank you.